Live from Cape Town, this is the Voice of the Cape. The Voice of the Cape. The Voice of the Cape.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good morning, a warm welcome indeed to your 10M Express. Here's Aisha Lanatu, and we have a special guest in studio with us this morning. That is Sarfaraaz, Mullah Treasurer, and also we have Moulana Waseem Hendricks, the son of the Sands of Worcester, who's the Imam at the Panorama Masjid, focusing on the Para-Muslim Community Trust and also the fundraising event that will be happening soon with regards to the Para-Masjid project. Moulana, to yourself, a warm welcome. Lovely to have you in studio with us. And to our listeners, don't worry, we have social distancing, alhamdulillah. Lovely to have you, Moulana.
Alhamdulillah.
And then we also have Sarfaraaz, Mullah, who is the treasurer. Assalamu alaikum to you. It's lovely to see, young blood involved, subhanAllah. Moulana, when it comes to, and I know that the masjid and the community, they're very close to your heart, alhamdulillah. Please tell us more about, as the imam of the masjid, you probably, have that affiliation, not just with the musallis, but with the entire Muslim community and the growth thereof as well. Since you have been appointed as imam at the masjid, how did the community grow?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسول الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته and Aisha and all the lovely listeners of the Voice of the Cape, mashallah. Yes indeed, and Aisha, actually it's a very special time in my life now as I would soon be serving the Panorama Masjid for 10 years.
Subhanallah.
Allahu Akbar, and I can't believe it because it still feels to me like yesterday, and the intention that I made the day that I was appointed in the masjid was at Asr time, and I made dua with my first sajda in the masjid. Ya Allah, let me die in this position.
That
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed me today, and may I be a benefit to the community at large, globally, inshallah. And I can see, as I've grown throughout a few years now that I've been serving, alhamdulillah, in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the community has grown, it's tremendously into Asia. I think when I started there, it was a very small knit community. I had the madrasa that is at the Panorama Masjid that had about, between 70 and 80 students. Just before lockdown, when we closed down, we were about 211 students, subhanAllah. So we can see how the families have grown since I started up until now, alhamdulillah, and it's still growing.
And when you say 211, is this only the morning, afternoon, and perhaps is it?
No, that's only the afternoon.
Only the afternoon, maktab, yes. Subhanallah.
Then we have the Hif school in the morning where we have about 90 students. We have obviously another school that is on the premises, Sheikh Isa al-Jazairi. Sheikh Isa Sami, he's running a school, about 60 students. And then we have Mualima Kashifa Lont that is also running her institute, Umul Quradi, which has also a substantial amount of students.
I think it's a great stride for the northern suburbs.
Definitely,
to have,
Aisha,
something like this, in the heart throb of the...
It's the hub. It's becoming the hub, alhamdulillah. And we hope that it should be that, and that is why this project is so important. I'm sure everybody knows me, myself, Mawla Waseem, but a little bit about Sarfaraaz. And Aisha said it's nice to see young blood, and wallahi, it is so nice because Sarfaraaz is very determined, he's in what he does. He's passionate about it, and so he is the treasurer today, and he's also a chartered accountant, subhanallah. So it shows us that we have chartered accountants who have the interest of the masjid at heart at such a young age. And mashallah, may Allah bless him, and may Allah take him from strength to strength. And then we also have our brother Asger Khan, that is also going to be, inshallah. Asger, by profession, he's an engineer, subhanallah, by trade. He is, mashallah, very good at what he does, and everything that is happening is under Aisha's here, mashallah, is to the point. Everything must be, in order, mashallah. And he is brilliant in what he does, and he's also going to lead us today in the exciting news that we are going to relate to the entire community now, inshallah ta'ala. And we hope that everybody is going to partake in this, because just to mention the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is with regards to our masjid. So it is not our masjid, it is our masjid, where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that man bana masjidan bana Allah lahu baytan fil jannah, that whoever participate, if we can't afford to purchase and to contribute towards an entire masjid, the little bit that we give, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us and build for us a similar or better
abode
in the Akhirah, in Jannah. Mm-hmm. In Jannah, not in the Akhirah, in Jannah. So this is like almost a guarantee that Allah gives you. You will get your house in Jannah, subhanAllah. Mm-hmm. So here's an opportunity for everybody to chip in, inshaAllah ta'ala. And Sarfaraaz will give us a bit of the history of the Panorama, the Paro-Muslim Community Trust, which is the Panorama Masjid. And then Asger will take us further, inshaAllah ta'ala.
InshaAllah, shukran for that, Moulana Sarfaraaz. So it's all up to you. And we know, knowing the finances, you can speak best of, you know, what can be done, what cannot be done, but also that shortfall that is so much needed as well. Speak to us more about it.
So just to give us a big, brief background on the Paro-Muslim Community Trust as it stands, it has its origins with the PMA, which is the Paro-Muslim Association, which was established in 1996 with the purchase of a house in Park Road, which was used as a salakhana and madrasa. And as the Moulana's already mentioned, that the community's grown over the years, and with that came the need to establish ourselves as a more permanent structure, with a more permanent structure and a larger premises in the northern suburbs. And so in 2008, when the Wendy Way property became available, the community was requested for assistance to purchase this property, for it to be used as a masjid and as a madrasa for the growing number of musallis in the area. Subsequent to that, in 2011, the property next door to the Wendy Way property, which is situated at number 5 Fiona Way Crescent, became available. And this property was purchased with the intention of earning rental income to subsidize the masjid, and also with the view to further expansion. And subsequent to that, Moulana has already mentioned that we've had a large number of Muslim residents coming into the area. And today, that premises hosts at least 1,000 musallis for jummas, for big nights, and for other spiritual activities that that take place at the masjid. And so it's really become a hub for our Muslim community. And alhamdulillah, with our building plans being approved by the city, we can now establish ourselves as an Islamic center. And it's with this that we come to the community, both local and extended communities, to assist us with raising funds. And not only to raise funds, but to also join us in this journey of establishing an Islamic center in the northern suburbs.
Investing in the Akhirah, isn't it, as Sheikh had mentioned earlier on. So, you know, you speak about plans that has been approved as well. So let's speak to the structural engineer, and that is Asger Khan this morning. Asger, assalamu alaikum to you and a warm welcome.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Auntie Aisha, and also a warm assalamu alaikum and greetings to the beautiful listeners out there. Alhamdulillah, it is by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have this opportunity to be able to present not only our appeal, but also our community, for the greater community out there. We wouldn't be here, and firstly, we would also like to thank you. You know, you haven't thanked. Allah's not pleased until you've thanked the people who have gotten you there. So, alhamdulillah, we are very grateful to the service providers who have rendered their service tirelessly to us, particularly Jacobs Parker Architects, and then also JZE Architects. So we just would like to thank them, alhamdulillah, for all the work that they've done to get us to this point. It's been quite a journey, and as Moulana and Sarfaraaz says, that we're bursting at the seams, alhamdulillah. And even despite COVID-19, we reopened on the 24th of June, and currently we are serving close to 450 musallis for Jumu'ah, alhamdulillah. And as soon as our doors opened, it was quite an emotional experience in that we missed the masjid when the doors were closed. So alhamdulillah, we've managed to reopen our doors, and the numbers are growing, and we've got very strong support. And with that, we have a need to serve the community and serve their needs. So what we would like to bring to your attention, it's not only an appeal, and it's not only about the finances, but also to inform of the struggles of the Muslims, pioneering communities in particular. if we look at the Panorama Masjid and our location, we are located just off the N1 at the Platte Kloof off-ramp. It serves not only the musallis of the area, but anyone on their way to Paul, they quickly want to make salah, they'll come off onto the Panorama and turn off onto Panorama Masjid. And in doing so, we serve close to 700 to 1,000 musallis for pre-COVID, for Jumu'ah, and currently 450. So with that, we've been, it is a pioneering community. It is also, being off the N1 and being so central, we are, it has become a hub. So it's become a Baitul Mal for our outreach program. Our community, alhamdulillah, we must say mashallah to everyone who's contributed. It's not an insular community. We have not only seen to our own, this Ramadan that has passed, we escalated, despite COVID, from collecting 500 food parcels for families, we've raised the bar to 2,500. Alhamdulillah, we got quite close. We got to 2,250. But alhamdulillah, I mean, that in itself is quite a tall order, but alhamdulillah, we managed to do that. And what we have currently is, just regarding our masjid at the moment, our requirements, is that we are, inshallah, looking to serve the community, and currently, and the subhanallah, it's amazing. Ours, our beginnings is a humble one. It's a double-story house converted into a masjid. Mm. There are bedrooms. You can see where the classrooms are, and these are bedrooms. Yes. The ni'mah of having those compartmentalized areas has allowed us to serve 450 musallis for Jumu'ah. So subhanallah, it's amazing that despite the constraints of having little bedrooms, we are now able to serve because you can compartmentalize and isolate musallis and have different entrance and exit points through sliding doors. So in that, we would now like to build the madrasa facility away from those little bedrooms and classrooms. By having the madrasa facility, which is adjacent to our current property, inshallah, we'll be able to move 7 classrooms, which are 39 square meters. And to give you an idea, it's a size of a double garage. Mm. That meets the Western Cape Education Department's requirements. So it would be able to serve as both a WCED classroom as well as for, so it could be combined secular and Islamic education, inshallah.
And I think that is what our listeners and our community is really looking for, that the child would not lag behind on the secular education. So, you know, doing it simultaneously will also give the parents some peace of mind as well. Will any of the education that's currently happening, and we know lots because of COVID-19 has been done, you know, online as well, but looking at, you know, learners returning physically and with you having to do these structural changes, how will that affect teaching? Are the children back at school yet, or is it still happening online?
So, alhamdulillah, we've had a very, very good response from the online madrasa, and alhamdulillah, they will be writing exams, and for everyone's safety, we've requested that that happens, and because it has been working so well, alhamdulillah, that will still be done from home. Inshallah, in January, we plan to reopen. The beauty of our project is that there were two urban that were consolidated, and this again brings the topic of spatial justice. Being in the northern suburbs in a predominantly previously white area, it has been quite a struggle. We've had 3 years of getting the approvals plans in process. We've had high-level officials working against us. And yet, despite all of that, alhamdulillah, and then we've had officials who were very favorable to the project as well. I must give a balanced view. And alhamdulillah, despite all the challenges, we went through all the protocols, all the red tape. Everything was done above board, and we managed to get approvals in place, alhamdulillah, to build the madrasa facility, which is going to actually serve as the future masjid temporarily while the greater phase 2 masjid gets built. So it serves a dual purpose. And alhamdulillah, the way the classrooms have been designed with stackaway doors is that when you open up those stackaway doors between those 39 square meter classrooms, you end up with mini halls. So the idea is that when we open up those stackaway doors, we have halls with each floor level having its own kitchenette, which is able to then serve as a mini hall to make us self-sustaining. So we don't come begging bowl in hand. We say we want to be self-sustaining, inshallah. So your contributions that you do make, it will be sadaqa to jariyah. It will also assist us. I mean, and it will assist us to generate income to complete phase two of the project, inshallah.
So just a question. You have the plans in hand. Obviously, you have a quantity surveyor looking at your plans, and you have a bill of quantity. So what is the cost from a financial perspective? What's the needs there, Sarfaraaz, financially? How can people contribute?
So the total cost of the project, you're looking at approximately 11 million rand.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the ways that we can contribute is to make an EFT to a PMCT net bank account. The account number is 123-214-2336, and you can put a reference down as building.
Okay.
And that is one of the mechanisms that we are using to collect funds. Asger can elaborate on a few of the other mechanisms.
Are there any other fundraising events that will be taking place soon? Tell us, Asger, before we run out of time.
No problem. Okay, so alhamdulillah, we've been very fortunate. So one of our first funds, we missed 17 weeks of Jumu'ah collections. And what we did was we had a drive-through, which was quite interesting. You could place your order via WhatsApp for your panat of Akni, and you didn't leave your car, you wore your mask, and you rolled down your window, and you collected your panat, alhamdulillah. And that was the big beginning. It planted the seed to make us collect through the COVID period, alhamdulillah. Mm. So that shows you the spirit of our community, that no matter what the challenges are, we will find ways around it, inshallah, and we will still be compliant.
I love it when you say community, which means you were supported by the non-Muslims in your community as well.
Indeed, we run a Discover Islam program from the masjid. Okay. Our masjid is a hub. Alhamdulillah, it serves as a base to serve areas of Delft, Fakhreddin, Elsie's River. And so it's not, as I mentioned before, not an insular community.
Yes.
It's far-reaching. So what we are currently doing is we are currently going through a rebranding process. We were very dependent, still very a little bit archaic with our Gmail accounts and so on. Alhamdulillah, we've got a website domain. Do not go there yet. It's not
still
active,
under construction.
Inshallah, under construction. But inshallah, it will be going live towards the end of next week. Inshallah, the domain is www.panoramamasjid.co.za. So Panorama Masjid, one word, .co.za. When you go to this website, there will be drop-down menus that will tell you about our various programs that we run. And please be patient, because obviously that's still in development, but the drop-down menus do work, alhamdulillah. We will then also have various other payment gateways. We know that people are a bit conservative, and not everybody wants to sign a pledge form. But what you can do is, on the spur of the moment, if you feel like doing a payment, we will have we'll be using facilities such as PayFast, etc., and SnapScan on our pamphlets, inshallah. So we are moving with the times, and we are trying to move to a new space and go through a digital transformation of our masjid, inshallah.
I mean, really progressive, alhamdulillah. Moulana, I must say, well done. Your team is on the ball, alhamdulillah. We know Moulana very passionately about his community, alhamdulillah, and just having the young blood with him as well, and that support. And I think, you know, without the support of a community, it's very difficult for the imam to perform his services as well. And Moulana has given his all. He left his hometown to serve the people of the northern suburbs, alhamdulillah, and doing, you know, so very aptly, alhamdulillah. And your support, but you know, we've got banking details here. It's net bank, it's PMCT 123-214-2336, and the reference is building. If you wish to contribute that 11 million we need by before the end of the year, we should put a deadline to that as well. So, and that is how, you know, we never know how death knocks at our doors at any moment in time, and to prepare for the akhirah is very important. So if you delay today, you might not be able to benefit, you know. So this is an opportunity. It's not you coming to beg for assistance, but it's you giving our listeners an opportunity to really attain their Jannah, subhanAllah. So with that said, you want to say, you know, to the treasurer, being an accountant as well, so knowing how to work with the monies and the money matters. So, you know, in the past, people would say it's the builder that's the treasure at the masjid. Here we have professionals doing these things, yourself as well as a structural engineer. You know what is happening on the ground with regards to building as well. So nothing can go wrong. You'll be there at all times as well, alhamdulillah. So from our side, we want to say to Moulana, to Sarfaraaz, to yourself, Asger, we want to wish you all the success, inshallah. And hopefully this is not the first time we'll have this type of interview with you, because we'd love to, you know, to track the progress on the building itself as well in future, inshallah. But we know to all the students that will be writing the exams from the school, we want to wish them all the success as well. Any final words from your side?
That is exactly what we wanted to say. Our hearts and minds are with, and may Allah grant them tawfiq, inshallah, to write to the best of their abilities.
Amen.
All our matriculants, we know it's been a tough year. The learners and all the students, may Allah guide you, inshallah, during your exams. And we say jazakallah khairan to all our community members who have assisted us in monetary terms as well as in kind. And inshallah, we will look at breaking ground early next, on the 10th of January, we'd like to break ground. We want to start the demolition process towards the end of November, inshallah. And for that reason, we strongly appeal for, if you can assist us, but it's more about awareness of our masjid.
Shukran, Asger. Final words from your side there, Sarfaraaz.
Shukran, Auntie Aisha. Just to extend on what Asger has already said, we thank the community for the assistance, and we also would like to wish the wider community and Muslims all over the world, you know, it's a constant struggle, as we know, and we wish them all the best, and we ask Almighty to put barakah in all that they do.
Ameen.
Inshallah.
Ameen. Well, the final words from your side, inshallah.
Yes, Aunty Aisha, I also want to include our entire executive committee, because they're not here, but mashallah, they also have been the driving force behind everything that is happening. You know, from the top till whoever, whatever little bit they contribute, they are, mashallah, a passionate executive committee, and I've been working with them for the past 9 years, mashallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take them from strength to strength.
Amen.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them their dreams, inshallah, because all of us who is actually a part of this and our wider community, we really want to see this masjid, inshallah, before we die. If not, inshallah, at least the rewards we will receive in our qabr, bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in Jannah. And then also the matriculants, and the Aisha, we can't forget them. We have a lot in our community and all over the community. May Allah grant them ease, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant, if every time when they open the paper, they see that, mashallah, I'm passing the paper already.
Ameen,
inshallah,
ameen.
Ta'ala, we want to see them successful, and we want, inshallah, opportunities to open. May Allah make nafahat for them, inshallah, openings for them, such openings that, inshallah, the future will look bright for our students and for our learners and for our youngsters, inshallah. For indeed, we know that it is a difficult struggle out there. Everybody speaks about it, but as being Muslim is so beautiful, that we say we put our trust in Allah.
Ameen.
Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And if they're looking for the gap year, Darta Folk is there for them.
We're ready for them, inshallah.
Mullah, shukran so much. All the success, inshallah. Ameen. Please barak in your time, and especially in the sustenance that you will be earning through this interview for the you know, the masjid and the better of our community. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum to all of you.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
My radio station, your radio station, our radio, The Cape.